Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. This video is going to be about some bushcraft uses for cordage and a toggle. I'm going to show you some of my favorite uses for them and how useful it can be. Let's get started. Okay, the first thing we're going to do in this video is show a quick way to put up a ridge line. Now, on the end of your cordage, a lot of times I tie a loop like this. Now you can loop it around, stick your line through the loop, and then pull out the extra. But if you got a lot of line, this can take a while. Let me show you an easier way. Okay, we'll start out with the loop, just like we had. Loop it around the tree, but instead of pulling this all the way through, here's our toggle. Just stick the toggle in the loop here and cinch it up. There, done. Let me finish putting up this ridge line, and then I'll show you another useful trick with using toggles and the cordage. All right, this is the way I normally put up a tarp on a ridge line. I make a loop with cordage, and then I tie a prussic knot. One, two, three, and then dress it. Make sure that they're all in line. Okay, here we've got a prussic knot with a carabiner, and I simply snap this carabiner onto the tarp. Then I can adjust the tarp wherever I want. But what if we don't have a carabiner, or we're trying to eliminate, you know, micro ounces and do something simpler? So let me show you on the other end what we can do. Here we have another prussic knot. Just slip this through and put a toggle in there. Then we can adjust our tarp to where it's good and tight. Just like that. All right, let's go on to another idea with toggles and cordage. All right, we just arrived at the campsite, and it's raining. The ground is wet. I don't really want to put my pack on the ground too bad, or I don't want to leave it on the ground. So this is what I like to do. Okay, now we need a little bit of cordage, a little toggle. Now, this is what I like to do, the knot I like to use. I roll it up, okay, like that. I roll it up again. And I pull this through, place a toggle in it, and cinch it down. Okay, let's do that again. All right, I roll this line over like that, roll it over again, and I pull this line through and stick a toggle in there like that. And cinch it up. Then I hang my pack from it, And I then have my pack up off of the ground, easy to get into, work from, and the pack is kept dry. Now, before we go on to the next thing, the next handy tip with cordage and toggles, let me explain this tree. It's kind of a neat natural occurrence. If you notice, this bark is stripped off. That's from moose. Moose like to strip the bark off of the willow trees and eat it during the winter. Now, willow bark is very high, and different varieties of willow are very high in salicin, which they used to make aspirin from, salicylic acid. So I don't know. I don't think the moose are eating it because of their need for pain-killing qualities. I think it's morally nutrition that they're after the bark for. Now, in a lot of tents, I need a lantern to hang a lantern somehow. Maybe I want to hang my boots or some gloves or a hat or my pants or shirt to dry them off, get them off of the floor and get them up where they can dry. So, even with teepees, a lot of times I will use a bipod on the exterior so I have the interior totally free of poles. It's not, you know, no pole, center pole is in my way. But I'll have a line tied from the ridge. Okay? Again, you do it the same way as we did the other one. We loop it over again, pull this line through, put a toggle in, cinch it up, and then we can hang a lantern from it. And that lantern is not going to slip. It's going to be there to stay. Now, the handy thing about this is you could put in as many toggles as you need to hang as many things as you need. Oftentimes, you know, I'll bang my head on the lantern and I'll want to tie the lantern up higher. I want to, you know, move it up or down the rope for different reasons, suspend it at different heights. When you go to untie this, you simply pull the toggle out, pull on the rope, and it disappears. You can then put it at a different height. There you go. Now, of course, it should go without saying that you may not want to hang a type of a lantern that uses a fuel to produce light, such as a Coleman lantern, a gas mantle lantern, or candle lanterns or such. Their heat might affect the synthetic cordage. All right, let's go to another use. Actually, it's going to be another use with the same knot, but in a little bit different usage. Now, with modern cordage, a lot of times you can have an extremely stout piece of cordage in a very narrow cord. This here is 550 paracord. It's capable of withstanding up to 550 pounds. There's no way I could pull anywhere near 550 pounds. If I attempted to, I'd tear up my hands. With this small cordage, you just can't grip it very well. So here's a handy trick that I often use. I will, just like with the lantern hanging and the backpack hanging tip, twist this over, loop it up again, pull the line through, and put a suitable sized toggle in there. And this toggle would become a handy hand grip. I can do it one-handed by straddling the string, or do it two-handed if it's a heavy object, and be able to lift the item, or say like a sled or something. You got a four-wheeler stock or something you need to pull. This provides an excellent hand grip to be able to pull an item or lift it, such as I'm doing in this case. Now, I mentioned earlier about I like to camp in teepees where there's a center vertical center pole. Now, the problem with most poles is they are very slick. How do you hang stuff from your pole? A pole is in a handy place to be able to hang your gloves, your pants, your hat, your socks, a lantern, whatever, to get it up off the ground, to be able to shine light on the whole tent area, etc. Well, this is a handy trick that I learned. Okay, I tie a loop, and I like to use the fisherman's knot on a lot of my loops. It's a very compact knot. So, we're going to tie the clem heist hitch. Okay, loop it around once, twice, three times. Okay, take your bottom end of the loop, shove it up through the top end of the loop, tighten up, and now tie a cow hitch. Okay, let me do that again. You take this, lay it up over your cordage, and then bend the two halves together, a cow hitch. Put a toggle in there, and then you can hang your item. And this is not gonna slip. Even on a slick aluminum center pole, this is not gonna slip. But yet, it's easily adjustable. So, like with a lantern on a teepee, sometimes I can't reach high, clear up into the peak to hang my lantern. So I'll tie this down lower, hang my lantern, and then I can get a stick or whatever and I can shove this clear up into the peak to get that lantern up above head height so I'm not banging into it. Sorry about the bush plane, but this is Alaska and we frequently have bush planes flying through our valley here. All right, let's go on to another one. We didn't bring a pot with us on this trip, so we'll just use my wife's water bottle and pretend that this is a teapot or a kettle or a coffee pot or something. Okay, you want to tie a loop in the bottom of your string. Tie your string to the tripod. Loop it through the bail of your pot. Run it up. Okay, now put it up to the string here and run a loop of the hanging string through it and put a toggle. There you go. Now, your fire that you're heating this with, there's a fly on the lid. The fire that you're heating this with, it raises and it lowers, and you'll want to adjust this. So to adjust it, you simply just adjust it. You can raise it or lower it wherever you want to, however high you want it. Okay, let's go through that one more time briefly. Okay, you tie a loop in the end of your cord, run it through your bale, bring it up here beside your, standing in, working in, whatever, and pull it through the loop like that and put a toggle in it. And then cinch it up. Okay, now if it's not working for you, you might want a smaller loop. You might want a bigger toggle. There you go. Now, here's another one. Let's go on to the next handy tip. All right, here's another useful trick. Now, disregard that this has been flattened. I don't think it really needs to be flattened. Just a round toggle will be fine. But put a hole through it. Put a hole through each end, near each end, okay? Tie a stopper knot. I'm using the Ashley stopper knot because it's pretty symmetrical on one end, okay? Now on the other end, slip it through the other hole, okay? You pull it through to the end, slip this one through, coming from the same side that this comes out. Okay, pull it up like that. Okay, now this is a guy line tensioner. Let's tie this off as if this is our tent. Just tie a couple half inches, whatever, to secure that. Then we go out, we take this loop here, pull it out, put it over our stake, and go ahead and tension our line. Go ahead and tension it however tight you want to tension it, however tight it needs to be tensioned. Works great for a line tensioner, quick line tensioner. There's other adjustable hitches that you can use, but this is pretty handy. So you don't have to tie any knots, you just got it ready made. Okay, let's go on to the next knot. Now here is a really handy tip that I learned recently from Felix Immler, and he got it from Detlev Nature and Survival, I think the name of his channel is. So let me show you. Now, to use this, we're going to have to bore a hole through it. I have an awl on this, but the awl is kind of big. I'm going to use a small screwdriver for this. And I'm just going to start boring a hole through here. I'm just using just my screwdriver. Trying to make sure that I keep it centered in the stick. Okay, we're about to come through here. There we go. We've got a hole bored all the way through. I'll continue to run this and ream out the hole a little cleaner, hopefully. Okay, I'm using a green stick because the green stick won't split as easily as a dead dry stick. Now that we've got the hole all the way through, hopefully you can see that. Let's run some cordage through there. Just the end of some cordage. Hopefully the hole is cleaned out good enough that we can get the cordage through. Yeah. There we go. Okay. On the other end, we've got a loop tied. Okay. Okay, now we're ready to use it. What this is good for is for cinching up things. Let's go ahead and put it in place. Now I'm just using this as an example, but you know, like putting a sleeping bag on a pack frame, or perhaps shrinking down a bag of a ditty bag full of clothing or something, trying to make it you know, more constricted, a smaller, take up a smaller area. That's what this would be good for. Okay, what you do is, okay, you've got your end up here. You run this through your loop. You have a loop tied on this, on the other end. Run this clear through like that. And then cinch it down. And then it holds it tight. It doesn't slip. Here, let's run this over in the middle a little better. Okay, cinch it down. And then it holds it tight. When you want to loosen it up, you simply just turn your toggle. And then you can loosen it up. Let's do that all over again. So hopefully it makes sense to you. Okay. You have this sliding on the rope. The rope is run through the hole. Okay. On the far end of the rope, you have a loop tied in. Slip that loop completely over the stick so that now you've got this loose end on top, and you just simply pull and tighten it up. Tighten it up as tight as you want, and it holds it. Holds it very tight. I said I got this idea from Felix Immler. Be sure and check out Felix Immler's channel. He's got an awesome channel that is very useful. He's a wizard with Swiss Army knives. He almost performs magic with Swiss Army knives. And I'm sure you'll enjoy his channel. Check him out. Well, that's it for a few of my ideas that I had for using toggles that I use frequently and have proven to be very useful. I'm glad you joined me on this video, and we'll see you on the next video. You folks have a good one, and take care. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.